Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Dutch Bushcraft Lives. Dutch Bushcraft Lives, your favorite channel in the world. It has been raining again and again because it is the Netherlands. We only had about 4 hours of dry time, so we thought this was the perfect opportunity to make an easy video. I mean, to make this video where we explain our destruction test.
Yeah, why do we do a destruction test? But and why do we have such an amazing giveaways?
It is the Valkenhaven F1X.
Thanks to Blade HQ.
Valkenhaven A1X.
Thanks to DBK. Magrific Gunny CPM3V. And this nice
custom handmade beaver knife from Russia with DBK pins.
We do our best for those giveaways because you literally keep this channel running. So thank you very much for making this all possible. So we like to do something back, and that's why we do it with a giveaway.
Destruction.
We thought it was important because we see a lot of
questions. Hate. A lot of hate.
Towards the destruction tests.
Yeah. And people say, guys, why do you use a knife for something that you would never use a knife for?
What? Why? Wouldn't you cut bricks with knives? Yeah. I do it with my favorite knives.
I always try to compare it, Mickey, with like the car industry. Yeah? I mean, a car manufacturer drives a car into a wall.
Just like my girlfriend.
Not because a car is meant to be driven into a wall.
No.
It is to see the limits of what the car is capable of. You want a knife to depend your life on, perhaps.
Yeah, then
you gotta test its limits before... somebody's gotta test the limits before you can say it is worth depending your life on.
And that is...
what we do.
Us.
Yes, us. Yeah?
So we're gonna talk about the brick hunting test.
The transversal batoning.
Hammer batoning.
Board throwing.
The gun impact test.
Muscled hammer guy test.
The standing on the knife test.
Yeah, that one is very scary. Metal chopping?
Wow.
Tip test.
Brass pin chopping test.
Whoa, that one is really good. It actually hurt a lot of my knives.
Yeah.
Okay, so to start off with this video, I just want to say that somehow Martin's been destroying all my knives this last couple of weeks. Holy fuck.
Mickey, your knife is too big.
I have a knife. My knife! But nonetheless, let's just keep a smile on our face and have a happy Christmas. So the brick cutting test falls into the same category as the metal chopping test.
And the brass rod pin thing chopping.
Whoa! Martin, did you say? You say it now.
It is to test out the toughness of the steel in a really extreme manner, of course.
Yeah.
But by hitting steel or stone, you can see, does the knife chip?
Yeah.
Does the knife roll? How bad does it chip? How bad does it roll? It tells a lot about the properties of the steel and, of course, the heat treatment of the steel.
Martin, the thing is nothing.
No, I mean, there are reflections on the edge, but this is crazy. No roll, no chips, nothing. Yeah. looks very bad from both.
Ooh.
Silky meets Mora.
Yeah.
I think the clone is a little bit tougher because it's just a lot softer.
Yeah. Listen, the next thing is in the same world as batoning. It's every test that you have to hit the knife on the spine with to test out that tensile strength. So,
yeah, and
for
impact
instance,
resistance.
The wood that lays horizontal, where you chop against the grain.
Yeah.
The hammer batoning test. Christ almighty! And the muscled hammer guy test is all kind of the same thing. You're testing out the tensile strength.
But tensile strength is eigenlijk buigen, hè?
You're not testing out the tensile strength. You're testing out the
impact resistance.
Impact resistance.
Yeah.
And because this same reason, this exact reason is why there's a little delay on our DBK knife.
Because we.
It's because there was little, there was some doubt whether if all these knives could hold up that batoning test to the max, and we don't want any of your knives breaking, even though the chance is like maybe 1% or maybe 0.001%.
With the impact resistance, you test out like the steel structure, integrity of the structure.
Yeah.
Does it have any cracks in the steel because of bad heat treatment?
Yeah.
But you also test out like the handle comfort, because you get like extreme shock waves through the knife. With some knives, the handle comes loose.
Yeah.
So then you can also test like out, my English feels really weird today.
wait. Now we have arrived to the last test, which tests out the tensile strength, which is the sideways pressure, the sideways strength that the knife can handle. Where we do the shooting, this is where we stand on the knife.
But shooting is like a combination of impact resistance and tensile strength, because it gets a huge impact and then it needs to flex a bit to cope with that impact.
Martin!
Holy shit!
What the
this
fuck?
This I would have never expected.
What?
Holy shit.
And like, there's a reason that we don't do all the tests with all the knives, because, yeah, for instance, we can do a tip test with carbon knives, but they will all bend. Stainless knives, they will probably more often break.
Yeah.
So then it's more interesting to do a tip test to see if, hey, is it gonna break?
Yeah.
While carbon knives, yeah, they're, especially cheap carbon knives, they're not gonna break because
and
they're gonna bend because it's carbon knives.
And there's also steel or knife design. You're not gonna do a tip test with a fish fillet knife, you know.
Speak for yourself. I'm not gonna speak for our viewers. Only recently we found out how amazingly good that destruction test with our FX Boss, our air gun, is, because, like, if you would do it with a normal gun, you would destroy probably all knives.
Yeah.
But if you do it with this knife, it is exactly at that level where it hits and destroys cheap knives, like it did the pen. It went through the pen like paper. So if your knife is good and strong, it will survive. If it is chippy, it will show. It will show its weakness. And that's
again,
why I love it. It exposes if the handle is bad. It exposes if the heat treatment is bad. It exposes if you are a bad shot, because you have destroyed a knife of mine by shooting the handle by accident. Ooh, and then right before the shot, Martin had dropped his rifle by accident. No pun intended, no.
My knife hit, the bullet hit the handle by accident.
And, and one very strange test that we do, but we think it is really good, is throwing the knife against the board.
Yeah.
You might
and we
think
get
that,
ooh, you guys can throw knives for shit.
Well, first of all, that's true. The thing is, that's good for this test because you want the handle to hit the board. You want to see how it.
It is not a steel test.
Impact.
It is not a steel test. This test is especially good for like folders to see how well the locking mechanism works, because it can unlock the lock.
It can make it wobble.
And the winner is, with the least amount of wiggle, the Benchmade. Sadly, the Meskwaki knife did not really survive this test completely.
And for fixed blades, it just shows how well the handle is attached.
Yeah. Can I talk about the giveaway already?
Yeah, you can talk about the giveaway.
Money.
Talk about it, bitch.
Oh shit, demonetized. Ladies and gentlemen, we're doing a big giveaway. Every month we do a new one. And this month we're giving away the F1X, the
Thanks
A1X, Bark River Gunny.
One of our favorites. And of course a handmade beaver knife with CPM 3V and custom-made DBK pins.
Anyway, thank you for Blade HQ for also making this possible every month. They making this giveaway.
Giveaway!
Hey!
It is so nice.
Bigger and bigger. Ladies and gentlemen, please like the video, because apparently that is good maybe for the algorithm. I don't know.
Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a great last month of the year.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I hope YouTube will bring us a lot of joy in 2021.
Dag.
Later.